This is Lawrence Bridges.
This is a Honda Scooter.
And this is Lou Reed. What is the connection between these three, you are asking yourself? Well, sit down and take a seat, because we're going to get in deep, do some deep diving, and dive deep down into this thing. Let's get down to brass tacks. Yo, yo, everybody. I'm Alex. This is Elements of Film. Welcome to another edition of My Favorite Dot Dot Dot, the only show on the internet that audibly sounds out the punctuation in the title of the show. In this episode, I want to talk about something so monumental, so important, so life-altering that the world as we know it would not be the same without it. That sounds like I'm being a little flippant, but I'm not. I want to talk about this. Can we roll the clip? Roll the clip, please. Can somebody roll the clip? Roll the fuck.
Hey, don't settle for walking.
How amazing was that? Okay, let me give you a little context behind the piece, and that might help explain why it's I feel it's so important and influential in the world of filmmaking. It's 1984. There's a small ad agency in Portland, Oregon called Wyden & Kennedy. I'm sure you've heard of them now, but back then they weren't what they are now. Around that same time, Honda was looking for an agency to help them pitch their scooters. Wyden & Kennedy stepped up and said, now here's our chance to make some cool shit. There was a young copywriter at Wyden & Kennedy named Jim Riswell. He came up with an idea and he pitched it to the Honda executives. Now, he walked into the meeting with no storyboards and no documentation, no nothing. He just walked in with an album cover and a cassette player. And he set the album cover up for everyone to see, pressed play on the, and a song came out. And that song was Walk on the Wild Side. And what he was doing essentially was pitching to Honda the idea of having Lou Reed as a celebrity endorser. That's right, Lou Reed as a celebrity endorser. Which is a crazy idea when you think about it. I mean, this is Lou Reed.
Do you want people to take drugs themselves? Is this perhaps why you sing about drugs?
Oh yeah, I want him to take drugs.
And this is Lou Reed.
Are you happier as a brunette?
Are you happier as a schmuck?
He's not like your first choice or your go-to choice of person when you think of like celebrity spokesperson. Honda says yes. They shoot the spot in Lower Manhattan. Now, keep in mind, this is the early 80s. Seedy streets, drug addiction, violent crime, all that stuff. That was Manhattan, especially Lower Manhattan at that time. Not your go-to choice when you think of a backdrop for selling a product, right? Apparently, the shoot does not go very well. Roll the clip.
Griswold always wanted to parade out all of his heroes. The first was with Lou Reed, which was an absolute disaster. All the film was underexposed. But we worked with this great editor. He saved our butt and put together all this fucked up footage.
That great editor that he just mentioned was Lawrence Bridges. He was tasked with going through the footage and trying to make something out of all of that. Before he was a filmmaker, Lawrence Bridges was a published poet and writer. He made the transition into filmmaking by working in music videos. He cut some Michael Jackson classics like Beat It, Dirty Diana, The Way You Make Me Feel. Music videos allowed him to creatively explore, to push boundaries and try new things, try new techniques.
I'm like a caged animal on the music video side, this other side of my brain, just wanting to break out and try everything, because that's how you survived in music videos. You would do the unthinkable. You would do things that were dissonant, things that made people confused, but that was good. You know, that brought that's the theory of cognitive dissonance. You do things that are so hard for people to understand that they eventually resolve the dissonance that they see in this newfangled presentation and fall in love with it.
Because Larry had experience working in music videos and in advertising, he was a no-brainer to come in and bring some of that music video experience into advertising. But Lawrence had such reverence for Lou Reed and that song in particular and what it meant to that generation.
Creatively, I came from the place of saying, well, what, you know, it was Lou Reed. It was the Take a Walk on the Wild Side. I said, I have to be careful here. I have to honor this. I know it's going to be an ad, but I have to honor it. I have to respect what this means to the culture that it's being promoted to. So I said to myself, what should I do with this? Oh, I better make an underground film.
So essentially, he took all this underexposed film, which in most cases would have not been usable. He took the scraps. He took the things that would normally end up on the cutting room floor, the junk. And he took all those things and he made it into something memorable, exciting, vibrant, alive, gritty, raw, real, and I think beautiful.
And the revolution in it was I used all the junk. You know, usually film... TV commercials are very controlled, storyboarded vignettes. But instead of using the vignettes, I used the whip pans and the runouts and the flash frames. The flash frame is when the film goes through the camera stops, you don't reload, you start it again. That one frame is exposed, so it's overexposed. And when you play it in real time, it flashes, flashes, flashes. I'm the guy that invented the flash frame. You can still see it. It's embedded in Final Cut Pro X as an effect. So I essentially created another letter in the alphabet of editing.
With this spot, Lawrence Bridges did two things. He essentially added to the vocabulary of film. He added new techniques. He added new ideas and new ways of doing things. He elevated the aesthetic of music videos and made them legit, made them part of the everyday film language. The aesthetic of music videos, which were considered like maybe one step above cable access at the time, these kind of raw and like amateurish production techniques, and editing techniques. And those editing techniques that were used kind of became mainstream norm a few years later.
I mean, this is the way filmmaking evolves. People try things, new techniques that become what everybody does.
It took a piece like this Honda Scooters ad to kind of elevate the aesthetic and make it mainstream and kind of open the door for this kind of process. And this spot influenced so much afterward. Needless to say, the spot was a massive creative success. Now, I'm a child of the 80s. This spot, along with several others that I found out Larry Bridges had a hand in, were a big part of my childhood. I watched a lot of TV. Something about the culture that you experience when you're a kid, that it's somehow like locked in time or preserved in amber. Seeing these spots always makes me feel nostalgic for my childhood. But not just nostalgic. There's another feeling I get too. I get a sense of longing for something that I never experienced. I remember watching these ads when I was a kid, and I remember thinking, oh my God, I cannot wait to grow up, and I'm gonna live in those ads. I'm gonna be a part of that world, and I just can't wait. As a child, it made me long for a future. But you grow up, the world changes, the culture changes, you change, and that path that you thought you were gonna take, you don't take it. It doesn't exist anymore. My wife says there's a Portuguese word for this. It's called saudades. I think I'm pronouncing that right. I don't know. Mark in the comments if I'm pronouncing it right. And if I'm not pronouncing it right, mark in the comments how I'm supposed to pronounce it. And while you're here, decimate that like button. Pulverize it. Have you smashed the subscribe button yet? Go ahead and just blast it. Looking at these spots now as an adult and looking at the work of Lawrence Bridges, it fills me with that same nostalgia that I had as a kid. But at the same time, I'm also filled with that longing for the future and that excitement of the future and the promise of what my future could be. And for a commercial to do that, pretty neat. If you like this video, please, again, obliterate the like button. And if you didn't like it, go ahead and subscribe. Check out Lawrence Bridges' YouTube site. I'll put a link below. Head over to elementsoffilm.com, get yourself a film kit, check out the site, swim around in it a little bit, explore it a little bit. How do I end this? Okay, I'll see you. Bye-bye. Okay, bye-bye.